he gave us some three, this thing, Amitabh gave three options, four options they gave, no? The chapters of which Quran is these chapters, 50 lakhs. It was from Panchratna.
Panchratna, you knew it?
I knew it, I was telling him, it's हमारी थोड़ी brain की exercise हो जाती है ना? Watching this KBC and they ask all from Mahabharata.
Yeah. Oh, wonderful.
That's good.
So what is this KBC? What is it?
That lady, she's come from a gaon, a social worker. Till yesterday she's won 50 lakhs. Today she has won 1 crore also. They show for tomorrow.
She knew the answer, this Pancharatna.
She took those helplines.
Okay. But usko mil gaya answer.
Helplines, two were taken away wrong months. So which two were left were uski piche se uski saas bol rahi thi Pancharatna, but she can't see there behind. Even I told him it's Pancharatna, these chapters which they are showing.
Are they supposed to help?
Yeah,
no. They are
there for half an hour. They sit
behind. Okay, so let's do our start of it.
शांति
ॐ भूर्भुवः स्वः चतुर्वरेण्यं सर्वो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्.
We're doing this three times or one?
No, we're doing one time. Because we added, we're going to do Asto Ma Sad Gamya, then we're going to do Tam Tomeva Mata. I didn't send it yet, but I think that's a good one to do.
That we know.
Asto Ma Sad Gamya, Tamso Ma Jyotir Gamya, Mrityor Ma Amritam Gamya, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुः च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्याद्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव मम देव देव.
गुरु ब्रह्मा
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Mesa Brahma, Tasmay Guru.
So they are saying something else, you also have to do something else.
I will say Sakshat from now on. Because I was saying Guru Re, both the meaning are same. Guru Re matlab only Guru is, but that's why.
Guru Sakshat hai, Parabrahma.
Both are fine. Because some people say that, some people say that. We will, I think Sakshat
sab log
acha
lagta hai.
Sakshat means he is.
He is, and Guru Reva means only Guru is. So both are same. Okay, so we'll start with Bhagavad
Gita. She also sings bhajan.
Yeah, we can. What we can do is we will do it at the end.
No, it's better do it in the beginning.
In the beginning, you want to do it. Okay, then we should. If you want to do the bhajan, then we have to start on time.
Yeah.
Right. Otherwise, you know, like we will not move forward.
Yeah.
You know.
Abhi the 11 baje. We're on time. This watch is not correct.
What's the time right now?
It's
11:02.
It's 11:05.
So, ठीक है गाइए आप, but you know let's
No, it sets a good mood.
गुरु शुक्राना गाइ जा पाएगा मन साचा पाएगा पाएगा गुरु के बगैर कैसे। दिशाहीन चल रहे थे गुरु के बगैर कैसे। दिशाहीन चल रहे थे किसी ने नहीं जगाया। अंधकार में परे थे किसी ने नहीं जगाया। अंधकार में परे थे गुरु ने जो कृपा कीनी। पार ब्रह्म से मिलाया गुरु ने जो कृपा कीनी। पार ब्रह्म से मिलाया बलिहारी उस गुरु पे जिसने अलख ये जगाया। बलिहारी उस गुरु पे जिसने अलख ये जगाया। गाए जा गुरु शुक्राना। गाए जा पाएगा मन साचा सुख पाएगा मेरे सतगुरु का जीवन। आदर्श है हमारा मेरे प्रभु जी का जीवन। आदर्श है हमारा बलिदान दे के अपना। इस बगिया को सजाया बलिदान दे के अपना। इस बगिया को सजाया पंचभूत से उठाकर। सतचित आनंद बनाया पंचभूत से उठाकर। सतचित आनंद बनाया बलिहारी उस गुरु पे जिसने राह ये दिखाया। बलिहारी उस गुरु पे जिसने राह ये दिखाया। गाए जा गुरु शुक्राना। गाए जा प्रभु शुक्राना। गाए जा पाएगा मन साचा सुख पाएगा।
बोलते ना शुक्राने में ना जीवन सरल हो जाता है। कुछ नहीं करो
एटीट्यूड ऑफ ग्रैटिट्यूड।
कल मेरी भाभी का बर्थडे था तो मैंने उसको बोला हैप्पी 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 बर्थडे। बोलती दीदी यू आर टेलिंग मी टुडे सो मेनी टाइम्स हैप्पी 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 बर्थडे। आई सेड ही एवरी ईयर गॉड गिव्स एड वन मोर हैप्पी बिकॉज़ ही गिव यू दैट ईयर।
दैट्स ट्रू।
तो बोलते हैं ना उठो सुबह रेस्ट रूम हो क्या उसका भी शुक्राना करो। सो मेनी पीपल हैव दैट मच ट्रबल दैट आल्सो ट्रबल
या
गोइंग टू बाथरूम
या या मींस एवरीथिंग इज अ ब्लेसिंग। एंड आई थिंक दैट व्हेन अनदर थिंग दे से दैट या इफ यू काउंट योर ब्लेसिंग्स देन यू डोंट यू आर नॉट गोना बी ऑलवेज अपसेट।
वांट टू कम हियर आत्मा
व्हाट यू हैव यू डोंट कम।
यू वांट टू कम हियर नो।
He likes to sit there.
It becomes light. Shukrana gaate jao to it becomes
smooth. Yeah, like.
Yes, definitely.
Which course are we doing?
So we.
Gita.
Ninth, right? Niyatam Kurupiya kar liya tha. Ninth verse of Bhagavad Gita. Is that what you're asking? Of chapter 3. Right?
Chapter 3.
Yajna tartha karmano nayatra lokoyam karma bandhanaha tadartham karma kaunteya mutta sangha samachara.
Oh, you're getting better?
Yeah, because of thanks to you guys.
Yeah.
I was like the last person chanting, but now because of you, I'm getting some himmat. Okay. So the English translation is, the world is bound by action other than those performed for the sake of sacrifice. Do thou therefore, O son of Kunti, perform action for that sake. And then in parentheses, for yajna alone, free from all attachments. So I wanted to bring this word called yajna spirit that we use a lot with children also. That whenever we do any action, do it in yajna spirit. So now we have to define what yajna spirit is. So you've heard that word?
Yeah.
So you want to discuss what?
Yajna spirit again is without objective. So every action you do, you can do like a yajna.
Yeah, right. So basically when you say yajna spirit, so jab hum log bolte hain yajna aur yagya, north mein bolte hain, to what do we think of ki bhai ek pehle jo hota tha na, yajna means that homam they call it, right?
Yeah.
That used to be always a community based one. Right. These days they started doing it at home
individually.
But in originally it was always community based. So then what people did was everybody brought in what they could contribute. कोई अनाज लेके आया, कोई लकड़ी लेके आया, कोई and so everybody contributed something, and the idea was for the benefit of the whole community. They're never thinking that is for myself.
Yeah, right.
Because these days it has taken a different turn.
Right, yeah. Right.
Oh, I have to bless my house. Okay, fine, that's maybe fine, but yes. The original is always that, the Vedic way of doing it.
Right.
And then they did it.
Havan. Yeah, they used to.
But even now when they do it, they always say bring everybody, bring all the friends. You never do it alone. You always,
of course.
Yeah. But in the original idea was everybody contribute for the good of the whole neighborhood, bolo ya family. So then they did it so that the devtas will be happy, they will rain will come, and there was some science in it.
Yeah, they used to do for
it. So if you remember that word, and now in that spirit you are doing it, so you're not selfish. That selfishness is thrown out. I'm not doing it for myself so that I get more money. No, I'm doing this because
for the community, home. Benefit of it.
Yeah, the rain will come and rain falls same on all of it, and the blessing from God comes to all of it. So what this verse is saying, that the world is bound by action other than those performed for the sake of sacrifice or sake of yajna. So now it's become clear. So if you do it selfish, you're going to be bound. That means you will accumulate more karma.
Right.
So that's that's what he means here. And then he's saying, therefore, perform action for the sake of yajna alone, free from all attachment. Last mein unhone wo jod diya. Free from all attachment. So then this is, because Arjun's question was, how do I act? So this is how he's saying. So let me see if the Swamiji has any other important thing over here. And in Swamiji's words, it is only unintelligent activities that thicken the impressions in the mind and thus successfully build a thick and impenetrable wall between the ego center and the unlimited divine spark of life in us. So like the yogis say that, you know, the reason they are meditating because they are trying to clear their mind so that they can see the substratum. So he's saying that unintelligent activities means selfish activities make that wall thicker in your mind. Then you will not see the God. It's like when the cloud gets thicker, you can't see the sun. So by doing So then, like you were saying, you know, about those ladies. I'm just giving an example. We are not picking on anybody. Basically, you know, sansar ki baatein karte rahe, where you gonna have time, right? If you have aches and pain and you call 10 people and tell each one of them the whole story about, so there are some people who do that. And it's like, why is other people not? They are not interested to listen to your doctor's report and this and that, but then you just don't have
it. But they feel better.
They may, but what I'm saying is, if we all indulge in those kind of things,
they burden your mind and feel better.
Yeah, I know.
No, but the question
no,
is...
No, because see, men and women, when men talk, they just talk to the point and shut it off.
No, I know opposite
when,
also.
When women talk...
There is one man, he's so obsessed with his wife's bimari that wo, agar kisi us, kisi ko pakad lega, to wo pura ek ghanta batayega ki kya kya hua, kya nahi hua. So, man, woman, kuch nahi hai. I think the point we are trying to make is that if we don't...
Sometimes if someone comes to know, he asks you,
yeah,
then it's fine.
No, but you can that agree. Means, yeah. Why do you have to be
yeah,
wrong?
You have to be very... You have to be
yeah, I was sick or my head is hurting, but I'll be fine.
See, my problem is opposite. When I was very sick, somebody will call me and I'll say, I'm great. So then when they call Nina, then she'll go.
She'll get out.
So she say, you're making me a liar. Anyway, man. One more antidote I want to tell about this yagna. You know when you do the yag or havan, you tie this roli around you. You know why they do that?
Why?
So many explanations.
Does anybody know that?
I know something, but you tell first.
Because in the olden days, this thing used to last many days. Okay. And people used to come and go. So when you tie that, you bind yourself that you'll start and you'll finish till the end.
Yeah, I'm feeling like it's a reminder.
Yeah.
It's a reminder.
Yeah.
No, that's a contract.
You have taken some
culp. Yeah,
they do it in one day anyway, when they do Havan.
No, right
then
now. There are
sometimes they say keep it.
But
the Mena Mena Havan is done only.
Yeah.
It can go on and on. Havan.
Yeah,
the Shani Havan I got done for me, that was 30 days.
No,
no, actually it was 90 days.
But what I've heard is that when you take a sankalp, this is sankalp thaka.
Yeah.
So when sankalp thaka is, you are doing the havan for what? And then, you know, like one of the reasons that we should discuss that in the Vedas, they have all these yaga and havans in the first part, major. Mm-hmm. So why did they put that? There is a reason for that too. Mm-hmm. Because when they used to do havan, there was a little protocol you have to follow. Otherwise, you haven't successful. If you want to bring the food, it has to be sattvic, you know, and you take shower, you do this kind of fasting.
Yeah.
So people who were too much into sansar, it taught them some niyam, yam niyam.
Mm.
So then once they started doing the yam niyam and they saw the benefit, say, "Arey, this is very good, man. I woke up early, I feel good, I'm going to do that again." So it gave them good habits and slowly led them to their nice life to go.
Plus it gives energy to the sankalp, because I know, I read this thing about, I don't know if you talked about this, but Sir John Woodruff. This guy was a judge of Supreme Court in Calcutta in 1890s. And he was trying to make a decision and he was very decisive. But every time he would try to think of deciding the case, he will not be able to decide. So he asked his clerk, he said, "What's going on? I cannot decide it." So he found out that both sides were doing this havan. And he said, "I don't believe that." So anyway, then when he retired, he went and studied Sanskrit and he understood all of this stuff, and he has written books now. They are by Ganesh and company on this Kashmir Shaivism and Tantra and everything. And he was like Sir John Woodruff, so they gave him a knighthood. But like, so that's, havan has power, actually.
Oh, definitely, it has power. But it has to be done correctly. That's what Because in olden days,
now they're doing this agro havan, isn't it? In Australia, in Scotland, and
what
Kaka,
agro
havan, they do yagya every day in the field, and they have tested that even radioactive material from the soil has disappeared.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah. Those are subtle energies. Yes. And they do for rain, and they say rain does come there.
Om has something.
Yeah, they do Om Bhubarva Sava. Yeah. They are chanting all
the time.
Well,
every
Havan is doing it. These do every day. They have a place where Havan gather, and they chant for 2-3 days. They chant.
See, they're building communities now.
Just think about this way. Sound has a lot of power. It can shatter your windows. Okay? So if the correct kind of sound can have some impact. Think, it's such a simple science.
No, we saw that. I said that thing, no dog. Sound, every sound has a wave pattern.
Yes, exactly.
And it makes a different pattern. So when we are saying Om, it makes like a perfect flower. Other things will make some other sounds. And they are saying they have done research on the brains that Om. Gayatri Mantra is the most powerful mantra in the world.
What goes on in the brain then when we say Om?
I think your brain patterns are changing, your neurons.
It is becoming calmer and you're, it is in tune with the
see,
universe.
See, when you're even taking heroin, you're taking drugs, everything
see,
is affecting
not
your
just
nervous
brain.
System.
It's not just brain. Actually, this fellow I met on the beach, he's an American Sikh. Like he, and he was doing research in UCSD in Department of Nonlinear Sciences on when we speak a word, our palate, the way it moves, it connects to the consciousness. So all of these words, Waheguru, Om, so here's a whole list of words which are worldwide, they are used. They said they all affect your consciousness.
Mm.
So he had the whole paper, I can find it, he sent me that.
So, all of those, Hari Ram is one of them?
Yeah,
Hare Krishna, all of these are in there. From every religion they have words.
Ram, Krishna, all those things are
all those. And because your palate moves and it touches your top, and the way you make the sound, you know, it connects to the conscious. That is what he concluded.
My book also talks about number of yajnas that we can do.
Okay, can I just finish what Swami
said,
and then
go.
You can say that it's better that way.
Oh, you have not, I thought you have
no, no, it's because he has said some important things and we should know. He said that before Gita came about, the word yajna only talked about this ritual. So he's saying that Gita is the one that gave it a new meaning.
Right.
When he said yajna spirit, he reintroduced this word and he said you can do yajna in so many different forms, you know, so that, because he's saying that when he said do it in yajna spirit, some people literally might say, hey, he was ready to fight, how he's going to do yajna over there? They even went that far. Did he want him to do yajna? No, no.
He said if you are rich, you do dravya yajna.
Whether
you give your money away. Same way, you know, knowledge yajna.
That was
action yajna. So
but
all of those are yajna.
For us, in
he's
this
given so many meanings of yajna.
That comes later. In this one, he introduced him that you need to work in yajna spirit, and he defined what
selfless yajna means. Basically
selfless for the benefit of everybody. And then, and here is saying for the purpose of cooperative spiritual and divine endeavors to invoke the grace of the presiding deity. For the blessing of the community, for the peace of the world, for the prosperity in the cattle wealth, the fearless and the good and all that. And then he said that, I put this star because I wanted to read that. Yajna here means only any self-sacrificing work undertaken in the spirit of self-dedication for the blessing of all. So you are sacrificing your stuff for that. And then it becomes self-liberating if you do it in that spirit. And it can be social, communal, national, personal activity, anything. But when you pour yourself entirely in the spirit of service and dedication, that's also yajna. That's what he's saying. And then another thing saying, he's saying that non-attachment. So he basically, when you come as a community and you do some job, You are not worried about the results at that point. Think about it.
No reward. You're worried about the result, but not the rewards for yourself.
No, you're not even worried about it because when I come, like, it's everybody's thing. So it's like, I don't think about that. I just pour myself into the thing because I just know that the results will...
Goodness for everybody.
Exactly. Do I at that time only...
And you don't
if you
know
really psychologically that. Think, we only worry about the result when it's our personal thing. Otherwise, we don't. We just, I'm going to do my best and just leave the rest. Because I cannot. It's such a big thing. How can I worry?
Maybe
imagine one person worrying about the results.
Maybe you want
possible.
To call it goal, not results. But so you have a goal why you are doing that.
No, goal
you
is
are
there.
Not worried
we know
about
why we are doing. But we cannot take the responsibility of the result
right.
on
yeah.
our head because
yeah.
we are one little drop in there.
Yeah. I know.
That's what I mean. You know?
That's true.
The psychology we have to understand. So, I already said reinterpretation of the word yajna is a very revolutionized over here.
Right.
And he says in this verse, he refills this phrase, the dead phrase yajna, with vital, life-giving content. And that's about it. So, what do you want?
What do you mean by life-giving content?
Because at one time people only thought of yajna as a ritual. He said, no, that's not what it is. He gave the word so much power that act in yajna spirit every day in your life. So he gave it a new meaning, new definition that happened in Bhagavad Gita.
So your life is giving yourself. not the this one.
Yeah, it gave, no, he's just yeah. You know, Swamiji has a very
the
powerful
life current is that only, you know, you're offering yeah. your services, that's what
right.
it is.
He's saying it gave life to that word, that's what yeah. he was saying.
But here, this just describe the various offerings. We can do Pitra Yagna that we do for our ancestors.
Okay, so that one you can
we'll
say
later.
But this one comes later.
My mind is given in this one only.
Okay, go ahead.
Then offering food to the hungry, so that's also another thing. Bhuta Yagna is offering food to the animal kingdom because they are less evolved. So, अपने में देते हैं ना गाय को रोटी ये सब
yeah,
sure. not doing anything. चीटी को भी दावत करते हैं. देवा यज्ञ, that is offering current from the senses as sacrifices to soul sight. What does that mean, देवा यज्ञ?
देवा यज्ञ is usually like
offering life current from the senses. That means you are controlling your senses, eh? To go towards
देवा उसको बोलते हैं all these five elements
your
that
indriyas,
we
soul sight, how to control
indriyas.
Your thing to go towards God. Controlling your senses basically.
I think when you say Deva Yagna means basically it's like acknowledging, in my mind, it's like not polluting the environment because they are, the five elements are out there and they are life-giving to us, which the concept did not exist in the West. Now they're realizing it after getting a slap on their face that they need to do that. But in originally from our Vedic tradition, we always worship the five elements.
Yeah.
Not as gods, but as Devas. Devas are like representative of God, which are giving us life, so we need to respect them.
Then the last one is Brahma Yagna, offering the soul on the altar of the all-pervading spirit.
Brahma Yagna is more like a recognizing that, you know, I'm representative of that soul, and that's why I'm working. That is the highest one, you know.
Yeah, so you're adapted to all your past, present, and
But this, whatever, this has come, actually it comes later on in Gita. But, and so we'll do one more verse of Bhagavad Gita. And then we'll move forward. This is 10. Saha yagna praja srishtva purovacha prajapatihi anena prasavishdhyame isha vo वो स्विष्ट काम दुख हार्ड ओके सो हियर ही सेइंग द ट्रांसलेशन इज अ प्रजापति द क्रिएटर हैविंग इन द बिगनिंग ऑफ क्रिएशन क्रिएटेड मैनकाइंड टुगेदर विद सैक्रिफाइसेस सेड बाय दिस शैल यू प्रॉस्पर लेट दिस बी द मिल्च काउ ऑफ योर डिजायर काम दुख सो दिस वाज अ लिटिल बिट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बट आई विल जस्ट मेक इट इन सिंपल वर्ड्स व्हाट इट इज दैट कृष्ण भगवान इज सेइंग दैट व्हेन दिस creation happened. Bhagwan bol do, creator bol do, in that capacity, total mind bol do, it had this rule bana diya samjho, ki you can literally achieve anything if you do this, this, this. Then that means, if you shall prosper and you will get what you want if you act in that spirit. So progress hoegi tumhari community. And then here in the commentary, Swamiji is saying that we know that if somebody, even any a corporation ho, kuch bhi ho, if they work for the benefit of the whole community, you always prosper. But when people become selfish, you know, start filling up their pocket, we don't need to tell you what happens. What happened in India and here also, Enron happened in Houston, you know, the whole thing came crumbling down. Whereas,
actually, here in Hindi, he's trying to say everything is given by to you by devtas.
Yeah, correct.
So have to
all the elements are by devtas only.
Yeah, but here you know what Swamiji always brings it to our responsibility because the whole Gita was Krishna Bhagavan was telling Arjun what you need to do, so that's why it come back to us that you know and that it was it's a rule. That hey, if you work like that, the whole community will be blessed. Otherwise, you will be in trouble.
Yeah.
That's all it means.
He's trying to say it's given by all the devtas, so you need to do that.
There are different ways of looking at it, the same verse, but the meaning comes to the same, you know.
Basically, you care for the universe also. That's what it is.
Yeah, that is a blessing. And then he also says it very nicely that when the srishti was created. You see the five elements, how they function. And that's how you need to function. When the rain falls, it doesn't say, अरे वो तो पापी है फलाना, वो तो उसी के ऊपर मैं गिरूंगा, उसी के ऊपर नहीं गिरूंगा. समान ओके व्हेन द इन द ट्री ट्रीज मेक्स द फ्रूट इट डस दिस इट्स नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर इटसेल्फ एंड इट गिव्स फ्रीली.
नहीं अर्थ इफ यू कांट से अर्थ इज द एलिमेंट नॉट द ट्री. अर्थ यू नो भगवान थोड़ी सी भी जमीन होगी इट विल ग्रीन विल स्प्राउट कहीं भी देखो.
वेट 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 व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज ट्रू बट ट्री इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अर्थ.
Yeah.
So when we say so, when
you talk about element, yeah.
Yeah, so your tree is five elements.
Earth, water, fire.
It's nature.
Yeah. Even sun, it shines on
for everybody. Yeah, the fruit is for everybody. Yes. Yeah.
So it's coming from the earth.
For everybody.
And it's for everybody. Then if it's a water, water doesn't discriminate. Or air.
Yeah.
You know, we can say, this is my house, this is their house. Air is the same.
Yeah.
In every house. So he's saying that if you see the spirit of this self-dedication, yagna is going on in the nature 24/7, and you take the inspiration from them that look how they are functioning, that's how I need to. And then everybody will prosper. That's what he said.
Yeah.
I thought that was a beautiful example.
Yeah, yeah.
Because we can relate to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And here he also says that no achievement is impossible for man if he knows how to act in the discipline of self-cooperation. And that's why you see humans can achieve. Sometimes you see their creation and say, wow, how was this done? But there was some behind it, some cooperation was there of people, you know. So those are the two verses. I think they're very inspirational.
Yeah, they're also saying during meditation, you see the yajna fire. That means you see the light. And then you become more connected with God and you become more intuitive. So that's also another one way of looking at it.
I would probably not worry so much because then what people do is, that's what the danger that we have been told. That if you say, oh, you're going to see this, then people cannot meditate. They always say, I have to see this.
Mm.
So when you're meditating, your goal should be
calm.
No thoughts, calm, and just leave it at that. And you have to leave it at for God. But if you're trying to look at an object, can be fire, can be light, you're going to be in trouble. You know? So, you know, that's the cautious that we have been taught to do.